Hello and welcome to this presentation. I'm very pleased about your interest in WINPACCS Cashbook. In this video, I'd like to show you its most important functions. My name is André Schaumann and I'm a senior consultant for WINPACCS. The software solution WINPACCS is designed especially for NGOs and consulting companies in the area of development cooperation. WINPACCS Cashbook allows to handle transactions of bank and cashbooks in a quick and easy way and still being audit-proof. In the next few minutes, I'd like to give you a short introduction to WINPACCS Cashbook. I'm going to cover the following topics: the login, selecting a project and a cashbook, the user interface, the help function, entering vouchers, changing voucher data, and uploading a voucher badge. But now, let's look at Cashbook, the offline application I would like to show you today.
When starting the program, you have to log in first. I use the email address and password from my WINPACCS user account. Based on my user rights, Cashbook recognizes whether I may use it at all, and if so, which projects and cashbooks are assigned to me. After you log in, you see here the cashbooks you used last. In my case, they are the cashbooks of the project office and a field cashbox. I just double-click a cashbook to open it and go to the vouchers menu. Before I'm going to enter a voucher, I would like to explain the user interface. There are the Start, Projects, Cashbook, Vouchers, and Reports menus. Depending on the menu I open, I see different functions and data in the tables. The Project menu is used to download and open projects. Each project in this menu corresponds to an actual project in the aid organization. Here, I can also update project data with changes in the cloud. The status bar shows a green dot if I'm connected to the WINPACCS cloud. If it's not green, I can still do all this manually without an internet connection. The cashbook menus lists all the cashbooks of the project I opened. In the vouchers menu, you can see all vouchers that have been entered in the cashbook. This is where you enter vouchers and create voucher badges for your project accounting department. I am going to show you how in a moment. The quick start bar also allows you to switch between cashbooks or even projects without having to click through the menus. This cashbook already contains vouchers. Using the table functions, I can sort and group them, for example, by recipient depositor. This way I can see who received which expenses or income. I can also use the search function to look for a specific recipient or depositor. For example, STC gas station. When I press F1 on my keyboard, the integrated user help pops up. It is context-based and explains the functions of the part of the program I'm using right now. For example, if I want to know what the column voucher status is, the help provides an explanation. Now I know that the voucher status indicates, and if I can still change the voucher's data, that is really good to know. Now I would like to show you how to enter income and expenses in WINPACCS Cashbook. I click New to open the window in which you can enter vouchers in the cashbook. The window looks simple and straightforward. It doesn't take long to learn how to use it. Only a few fields are mandatory. Those are the yellow ones: the voucher date, the entry text, and the amount in voucher currency. All other fields are optional and may be left blank. Using the simple example of a receipt from a gas station, I'm going to show you how to enter a voucher and will explain the most important fields. The first section, voucher information, is for entering the data of the receipt. It starts with the field recipient depositor. If you're entering an expense, you enter the name of the recipient. In this case, it's the name of the gas station, STC Gas. The program recognizes the name of a previous entry and I don't even have to type it in. In the voucher date field, the current date is pre-selected. For an earlier day of this month, I just put in 04. Month and year are completed automatically. Now I'm going to enter the entry text to describe the transaction. I put in the amount of fuel I find on the receipt. In the field Selection Income Expense, most vouchers refer to expenses, so I can just leave this button the way it is. It is pre-selected with expense. The amount is the total amount of the receipt, 5,545 rupees in this case. The balance prior to entry is the field that shows how much money is left in the cashbooks at the time of the expense. The expense may not exceed this amount. In the next section, Account Assignment, I can assign an account from the chart of accounts of the project which the cashbook belongs to. I think the account Running Costs Vehicles may be appropriate for a gas bill. The color of this field indicates that it's not a mandatory field. If I were not sure which account to choose, I could leave the field blank. The accountant who will be posting the voucher badge in WINPACCS accounting later would have to add the information. The same is true for all the fields of the next section, Additional Account Assignment, where I can add details on the funding and budget lines. If the project is funded by several donors, you can specify which one the expense belongs to. In this project, there are two budget structures. The first budget line is for the reporting purposes for the donor, EuropeAid in this case. The second one is for reports on expenses by region. In the last section, Additional Information, you may add further information, like a check number or invoice numbers. In this case, we can just leave it blank. I complete the entry process by clicking Enter Voucher. Once a voucher has been entered, it can never be deleted anymore. You know, erasers are a big no-no in accounting. However, you can correct wrong entries. To keep the cashbook transparent and to prevent manipulation, voucher data can only be changed until it's forwarded to the accounting department. The amount and expense income fields can only be edited on the day the voucher was entered because they affect the balance of the cashbook. Now that we have entered a voucher, I would like to show you how the pre-entered vouchers can be forwarded to the project accounting as a voucher badge. Oftentimes, cashbooks are kept in location different from where the project accounting is done. For forwarding the voucher badge to the right accountant, we're going to use the WINPACCS cloud. The voucher badge is created in WINPACCS Cashbook, uploaded to the WINPACCS cloud, and downloaded by the WINPACCS accountant to accounting. I just click voucher badge in the next window. I create a voucher badge by clicking New. The voucher badge contains all vouchers from the opened cashbook that have not been forwarded before. A report that lists all the vouchers is generated automatically. The green symbol in the corner shows that I'm connected to the WINPACCS cloud. The data are uploaded automatically. The accountant is notified that a new voucher badge is available, can download it, and can post the vouchers.
This was my short overview of some of the basic functions of WINPACCS Cashbook. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for your attention.